September.
New tonight, the sheriff's office says she was hacked, but won't say if they actually have evidence.
A racist rant was posted on the page of a deputy's wife after a brawl at Edison Mall was caught on camera. She says, though, she never wrote it.
NBC2's Nestor Mato talked to a tech expert to find out how investigators determine if someone has been hacked.
Well, that expert says even if you report the hacking, you may never get that confirmed from Facebook. They may just tell you to change your password.
So how would I know?
You wouldn't.
The N-word and go back to Africa, the most vile parts of a racially charged post on Linda Diverso Pakulis' Facebook page.
There is no reason to believe any member or even the wife of an agency member had any involvement.
Her name was on the Facebook comment, but Pakulis, the wife of a Lee County Sheriff's Office lieutenant, says someone else made the post.
The average person, there's no way you're gonna be able to look at her device and say yes or no, she was hacked.
Carrie Kursky is an identity theft expert and a former private investigator.
If they're trying to set someone up, a lot of times in revenge crime type of cases, we've seen it.
She says there are programs online people can use to try and hack your page. But without your login and password, it won't be easy.
Computer forensic analysis of the device or devices to see if there's any malware on there.
She says Facebook may have quickly helped detectives, but typically it takes more than a day to confirm if someone was hacked.
We weren't able to get things that fast, but then other times when we were working in conjunction with law enforcement, sometimes they were able to get things faster.
Well, Kursky says that this is a good reminder to go into your account security settings and sign up to be alerted every time your account signs in. I'm in the studio, Nestor Mato, NBC2.